Hello dear students, very good morning to you all. This is 5th class on dictionary. Class number is 5th. In today's class I teach you a very simple topic related to dictionary, that is how to add the items, means values, to a dictionary, as well as how to modify, as well as how to delete the items from dictionary. Means in today's class I teach you how to add, how to update, how to delete. Three things I teach you. First I teach you, already I taught you how to add. Once again I repeat for you. Adding a new entry to a dictionary. Here I have given one simple example for you, so that you can understand. This is one dictionary I created for you. A is the key for the item apple. M is the key for the value mango. It has only two values with two keys. Just you can check it. Just type fruits, we get the same thing. I want to add one more here, grapes, G for grapes. Then how to add? Just type fruits in single quote G. This is the key, then the value to be add. You can write the syntax for adding the new element also to the existing dictionary. How to add the syntax? First we use the dictionary name. Afterwards we type the key, then the value to be assigned to that key. This is what the syntax for adding an item to a dictionary. I hope you understood. Once you add this value for this key that is added at the end, you can confirm once again by typing the dictionary name. Fruits, A for apple, M for mango, G for grapes. Previously it was having two values, but I have added one more new value, pair of values, key with the value. This is what how to add new item to existing dictionary. How to modify? We can update the values from a dictionary with a new value. For example, here apple is the value for the key A. This one I want to update with capital letter apple. Then how to update it? Fruits of A, means A is the key. This value I am updating with the new value. What is that? Apple in capital. Again print the contents of fruits. Apple is in capital. That means that value is updated. Like this you can modify the existing value with the new value by using its key. Then how to delete? In deletion, three options are there. You can delete particular value from the dictionary, or you can delete all items from dictionary, or you can delete the whole dictionary. Three ways are there. First, I teach you how to delete particular item from the dictionary by using its key. I will now one list. I have A for apple, M for mango, G for grapes, B for banana. I want to delete this item, for example. Check out. Fruits is having apple, mango, grapes and banana. Delete fruits of B key I have given. That means this pair is going to delete. Deleted. How to confirm? Type fruits once again. Now we have apple, mango, grapes. This is deleted. This is what how to delete specific item from the dictionary by using its key. Now type fruits. Apple, mango, grapes is there. I want to delete all the values, all the items from it. Just I use the clear method. Fruits dot clear two parentheses. All are deleted from the dictionary. Dictionary is there, but that is empty dictionary now. How to check? Just type fruits. This is empty dictionary. You can delete individual item, or you can delete all items by using clear. Empty list is there. But I want to delete the contents as well as the dictionary. Then del dictionary name. Del dictionary name. That means entire dictionary is removed from the memory. Now just del fruits, check it. Fruits not found. Name error. Fruits is not defined. We are getting the error. I hope you understood. Very good. Next topic is the very simple one. That is sorting. Sorting items in a dictionary. I have one dictionary here. Alphabet. C for cat, B for ball, A for apple. Now check the contents. Alphabet C B A. Print sorted alphabet dot keys. Okay, just I am using the function sorted. Means keys from this dictionary will be sorted. A, B, C. Not only keys you can sort the values also. Print sorted alphabet dot values. You can use keys method to sort the keys. You can use values method to sort the values. Or if you don't mention keys and values, it will sort keys only. I hope you understood. We have one dictionary alphabet. I am trying to sort the keys and print A, B, C. I am trying to sort the values and print A for apple, B for ball, C for cat. Then if you use simply the dictionary name, keys will be sorted. This is what you can sort like this. And this is very interesting program. You may get this question in annual examination also. What is that? Write a program that prompts the user to enter file name. Whenever you run the program, that will ask you to enter the file name. Then that program will open the file and it will count the frequency of each word in it. Means you give one file name, that file will be opened by machine and it will count each word how many times it is there. See, let us assume we have one file1.txt. Welcome to the world of Python. Have a nice day. Welcome to the world of programming. Welcome word is how many times? Two times. Two times. The two times. Word. Two times of two times Python once have once a once nice once day once programming once this output we have to get. See the output. Welcome two the two world two of two Python one have one a one nice one day one program one. How to write the program? It is so easy. First read the file name. How to read the file name? Input, enter the file name. Assume that I enter file1.txt, that will be stored in file name. Then how to open the file? Already you know, open into bracket that file name. That file is opened in reading mode, read mode by default. Then counts equals to dictionary. One new dictionary we created as a counts. One empty dictionary is created. No items inside. For line in file, means from the file line by line we extract. We take the first line. Welcome to the world of Python. And line dot split, split method I use. This line will be splitted into, means divided into words. Those words are stored in words list. Now words is a list. For word in words, from this list I extract each word. Welcome to the world of Python. First welcome has been taken. It will check welcome is not there in counts dictionary. Yes, first dictionary created by us is empty one. Yes, welcome is not there. Not there means that will be added. Welcome with the count 1. Welcome is a key. 1 is the value. If not there, 1. If it is there, if the same word is there, we add one more 1 to the previous value. I hope you understood the same logic whichever I explained in my last classes. Like this, next 2 will be taken. If it is there, it will be added. If it is not there, it will be added. If next 2 is not there, add. The is not there, add. World is not there, add. Off is not there, add. Python, add. Have, add. A, nice day, welcome. Welcome is there already, then else part will work. Welcome's value becomes 2. 2's values becomes 2. If it is there, it increments by 1. Print counts, that's all. It's a very easy program. I hope you understood. Last one more program. Write a program that combines the lists to a dictionary. We have two lists. One is keys list, one more is values list. Keys list is having the key values, rule number, name, USN. Values list is having the values. I want to combine both and I want to create a dictionary. How? We use built-in function called zip. Zip into bracket keys comma values. It creates a single object. It creates a single object, not dictionary. That single object is there in details. Print details, zip object will be printed. Okay, then this details you have to convert into dictionary. Already we know about the DICT built-in function. That object contents will be converted into dictionary, that will be stored in dictionary. Print dictionary, rule number, key is assigned to value 1, name is assigned to John, USN is assigned to so and so. It is very simple program. we combined two lists into a single dictionary by using the function zip as well as dictionary. First we create the object, then we convert into dictionary. I hope you understood. Very good. Have a nice day. In the next class, I start you the next topic, that is tuples. Don't miss the class. Thank you. Have a nice day. Take care.